For children, there's nothing like getting that chance to talk to Santa.
We like to talk. Now, you can sign and use your voice at the same time, right?
Okay, these now, children communicate in a special way. They can't hear the things others do. But like all children, their wishes are the same. Old Saint Nick understands their Christmas desires through the magic of an international language, love.
Pink, a pink bicycle. Bicycles, games, and go-bots, and you're finished. But you don't want a doll? Oh, all right, I understand that. For girls, you're right. Hello. Hello.
Opa.
Oh, yes. Look up there and smile.
Opa.
Santa Claus, yes.
It's a day filled with memories for these children. Their curiosity of this age-old gift-giver has been satisfied. Ann Nyberg, News 4. Their faces tell the story of battling the frigid temperatures and bracing against today's extremely high winds that fanned the blaze. Those fighting on the front line were also up against intense smoke that seemed to swallow the small army, making their job even harder. Still, they kept the water flowing to contain the inferno to one building. There were other heroes on this day, those that saved the lives of nearby residents unaware of trouble.
The guy running around, banging on the doors, yelling, fire, 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 that scared me more than anything. And, but boy, you could hear him. I tell you, I heard him yelling, fire, fire, on all the other. And then, boy, when he came up to my door, it put a scare into me, really did.
Other residents looked on with amazement, feeling lucky that the fire wasn't spreading their way. Firefighters spending the better part of the morning battling the fire found their hands nearly frozen and their gloves wet. Still wearing them seemed better than nothing in the cold.
Yep.
This stubborn fire was brought under control quickly, and although many would like to end work for the day, they know another call could come at any time. Ann Nyberg, News 4.
On Friday or somebody else? Okay.
No, he's coming and bringing his financial.
That's right, we have a historical society meeting on Friday.
He's bringing his financial.
We're at the point where we need to either run this as a little in-house program in Tahlequah, Oklahoma, and with some outside markets, or we need to look at the idea of joining up with someone who has access to venture capital and look at it as a business.
To create jobs.
To create jobs. Yeah. Well, there's not been any large job creation.
About 65 people as our peak, and we're down to jobs with a business, or we generate the jobs with the profits from 60.
Right. So you're faced with how do you raise $1.5 million to do this? Well, you scrounge this here and you scrounge that there, and you beg from this person and borrow it from there and put it all together and make a project. And that's sort of what you've done here.
So what was the original federal training grant was for how much?
The original was about $80,000.
I'll read. Counts.
I can't believe that the judge could actually let a murderer out of that courtroom free to go out and kill other kids besides the two he's already taken in.
I could approve without any doubt at all. Those girls are still alive. We've got pictures of them. We've got them documented being across the country working as prostitutes and working in porno movies. We've got them on drugs. We've got them everywhere. There's no doubt in my mind that we could approve that Roy Long had no contact with those women.
And then if they're wrong and my daughter isn't alive, I expect him to publicly apologize to the public for even...
I don't believe it. I don't believe that he can prove that my daughter or Cindy Pellet is alive. It would be pretty heartless for anyone to claim that they could prove our daughters were alive and not have them home. And if I feel like if he thinks they are and he can prove they are, then he should bring them home.
To my knowledge, sir, no one has been told how to rule or to consider other things.
Consideration and modification. But when you have completed your study and have reviewed the entirety of the information and record before you, I believe you will conclude as I have that the Corporation Commission is an effective and competent agency, that its staff is professional and expert, that it serves well.
but this has come under much soul searching. We have already witnessed the aggressive nature of our district attorney, and we, since the permanent injunction has been granted, we don't desire another scene, and nor do we desire the jeopardy of our children or the ministers. So We Believers Ministry has been indefinitely suspended until January the 3rd, at which I will make another statement.
Everyone keeps asking her what she wants for Christmas, and she says she's already gotten it, that she wanted her transplant, and that's what she got, but she has lots of other packages under the tree. And we just hope that everyone has as nice a Christmas as we're going to have.
By losing two men on a department of this size, you need every man you can get, because we don't have volunteers in the city of El Reno. So that's two more men we won't have on the fire ground, which could be out helping to save lives or save ourselves.
Been well kept in that ice water.
Lincoln County Sheriff Ray McLean and his men have been scouring the Deep Fork Riverbank since Saturday afternoon. That's when young boys spotted their dog playing with a partially decomposed human leg. Searchers have combed more than 4 miles of riverfront in a grisly quest for the remainder of the body.
Oh, it's right here. You can see the dark imprint right into the dirt right here.
The state medical examiner's office says the leg belonged to a white female in her 20s. Medical experts determined the limb had been removed with a sharp instrument.
And I strongly suspect that it may have been surgically severed. So we may have other parts up and down the river that have been severed from a human body.
A dissection?
Yes, a dissection, which could be very difficult. We may never find the rest of the parts.
The headwaters of the Deep Fork River are in northeast Oklahoma City. The sheriff thinks the body parts may have been dumped into the river upstream, possibly near the New Arcadia Dam. A recent river rise could have deposited the leg near Wellston and other limbs either up or downstream. Sheriff McLean says his men will continue their search up to the county line. If they don't find the rest of this body, then they'll ask the Oklahoma County Sheriff's Office to continue the search farther upstream. Scott Wallace, News 4 near Wellston.
Caught fire in the air. There was a mid-air fire in the aircraft, probably in the cockpit, which filled the cockpit with smoke, and the pilots, of course, started immediately trying to find a place to go to. Apparently, from the looks of the men we brought in, the fire was getting pretty bad in the cockpit because they appeared to be burnt themselves, and they elected to try to land on a road, as I understand it, and at the last minute or in the final stages of the approach, something happened. Either some cars got in their way or something, and they elected to go to a field. And it appeared to me that they probably hit into some trees.
Well, what time were you and Mom expecting us for dinner?
We're not expecting you for dinner.
Yes, you are.
No, I told you. I met Connie's father at the drugstore, and they're not coming over here for dinner.
Yes, they are.
Well, no, they're not. Rick? Hello?
I'm here, Pop. I just couldn't talk.
Well, what's going on?
Well, I don't know, but Connie's mother and father are getting ready to come over to our house for dinner.
Well, they can't do that. Mr. Johnson told me you were supposed to have dinner over there.
Who's Mr. Johnson?
When I got to the garden party, they all knew my name. No one recognized me. I didn't look the same. You gotta play at garden parties. Wish you a lot of luck, but if memories were all I sang, I'd rather drive a truck.
It was a very strange evening. You know, it wasn't a thing where they threw anything at us or anything like that, but they did boo us. I guess they wanted me to look just like I came out of the 50s, you know.
And it's all right now, yeah. Learned my lesson well. Can't please everyone, so you got to please yourself.
You wouldn't have seen this sight 5 years ago. A sheriff's deputy patrolling Oklahoma County. Oklahoma County got its first marked patrol cruiser in 1981. Now it has 8 cars. Deputies like Lieutenant Don West don't wait for crime to happen. They try to prevent it.
The high visibility that we have out here is has cut crime down quite a lot, because today we've got a total of 8 cruisers out. And we have a high visibility within the rural areas of Oklahoma County.
The number one crime the deputies watch out for is daytime burglaries. The seclusion, which attracts honest people to rural Oklahoma County, also attracts burglars. Unattended, isolated houses have always been easy pickings for crooks. Now the criminals have to worry about being watched. Lieutenant West says he's nabbed 8 burglars during his patrols. The deputy says the patrol cars have made a big difference. He now tries to catch crooks instead of catch up with them. Scott Wallace, News 4, Northeast Oklahoma County.
And when I'm on emergency trauma call like I am today, there's a good chance I'm not going to get a whole lot of sleep tonight. But if I do, there's also a real good chance I'm going to wake up right here on this old couch in the morning, just like I have hundreds of times before. The longer I've done this, the more I'm impressed with how important it is to get plenty of sleep. Many Americans suffer from some type of sleep disturbance. In other words, they can't sleep well, and this is not normal. One such disturbance is known as insomnia, or just the inability to get enough sleep at night. Probably most cases of insomnia are the result of anxiety or depression. Now, if you'll just face up to the reality of these internal conflicts that are really causing this anxiety and depression, you'll probably be able to get some sleep. And there's a few other things that you can look at. Like, don't take your work to bed with you, and get some good physical exercise during the day. A good warm bath before you go to bed helps, and make sure you've got a nice, comfortable place to try to sleep. Now, if your inability to get enough sleep doesn't go away with the suggestions that I have made, and this lack of sleep begins to interfere with your daily activities, it's time to get some professional help. Let me tell you, if you don't get enough sleep, your productivity is going to go to pot, and you're not going to be any fun to be around. I'm Dr. Red Duke. You ever start off your day knowing full well that you slept a full 8 hours, but really don't feel like you slept any at all? It may be that a sleep disorder called sleep apnea may be robbing you of really what you need in the way of sleep, and even worse, interfering with your breathing. The most common hallmark of sleep apnea is snoring, loud and frequent snoring. Lots of people snore and don't have sleep apnea. But the characteristic that makes sleep apnea so worrisome is that the snoring pattern is interrupted by long periods of silence, during which the person really stops breathing. Rarely a patient will actually die in this state. Another characteristic of a person with sleep apnea is that they tend to fall asleep during the day and may even fall asleep at inappropriate times. And some of the manifestations of this state is a change in personality, sexual dysfunction, not to mention the fact that you may fall asleep while you're driving your car. But no matter how this condition may present itself, this is a problem that should be seen by a physician. Doctors today have some very sophisticated ways of studying sleep disorders and treating them. Now, these treatments can not only change, but possibly save your life. I'm Dr. Red Duke. You know, every now and then, all of us experience the feeling of sleepiness in the middle of the day. Seems like it happens to me every day between 4 and 6. Now, sometimes it's just a nuisance, but this condition can be dangerous. The person in the next room who's undergoing a sleep study has what we call narcolepsy. And unfortunately, some folks are misdiagnosed as either having epilepsy or hysteria. You know, it's really important for a person with true narcolepsy to be identified and treated because good treatment is available. The most common symptom of narcolepsy is what is called a sleep attack.
Using some machinery, you're driving, or you're walking, and you can suddenly drop. And a few minutes later, after you get your 5 minute nap, and then you're okay.
Cataplexy, or temporary or momentary paralysis, can also occur during these sleep attacks. People that have narcolepsy may also experience seeing and hearing things that really don't exist. Now, a person with narcolepsy can have any one, all, or a combination of the symptoms that I have mentioned. But by far and away, the most significant and important symptom is a sleep attack. If you or someone you know has these symptoms, it's important to get in contact with a highly trained specialist. I'm Dr. Red Duke.
I think that the farmers have finally come to the realize that if we're going to change this economic, you know, condition that we're in, we've got to get involved. You know, I think the farmers are beginning to see, you know, we've got the greatest story in the world to tell. And if we get out there and tell that story well, then we're going to be able to get support from the other segments of the economy.
Officers are looking for a 16-year-old black female suspect in this killing. Witnesses at the scene have indicated that the stabbing was the result of an ongoing feud between these two young ladies. At this point, we haven't established exactly what that feud was about.
Okay. One thing we're wondering.